My name is Gregory Bodicchio. I'm the product manager for SAP Business Project Web Intelligence. And with me today, we have the opportunity to have Christian Assoun, who is one of the lead product experts for Web Intelligence as well. We just have half an hour to share with you some good news. So let's say that I will speak the first 10 minutes and Christian will do a live demo of the 4.3 Size Pack 2 in the next 20 minutes. So let's move on quickly. So why BI 4.3? Well, first of all, I like to repeat myself because you are hearing a lot about SAP Analytics Cloud, but SAP is committed to continue to invest into your on-premise BI suites, and the BI 4.3 is the proof that you continue to innovate on-premise in the BI on-premise. So if you go quickly in the portfolio, we have two stacks today, two solutions that we are proposing to you. SAP Analytics Cloud, for customers who are willing to go to the cloud, who are looking for a software as a service solution. And if you decide to use SAP Analytics Cloud, you're going to find very good, very great things such as BI, planning, and predictive inside one and single tool. And if you decide to stay on-premise, you can continue to use the SAP Business Object BI suite and the great BI 4.3. It's important to notice that even if you have two solutions, we are investing in a third area to make sure that both solutions can work together. You are working on interoperability, which means that things that you have developed inside SAP Business Object BI suite can be reused with SAP Analytics Cloud. For example, that's the case for the universe. So your on-premise universe can be leveraged by SAP Analytics Cloud, but not only the universe, but also your web, all your existing web intelligence document can be used as a source for SAP Analytics Cloud. Quickly, really quickly, I go really quickly today. So this gives us the SAP BI portfolio 2020, which is also true for 2021. For companies who are looking for the cloud, SAP Analytics Cloud, for BI planning and predictive. And for companies who are willing to stay on-premise and use the BI, Business Object BI suite, we recommend three tools. The first one is Web Intelligence, of course, for ad hoc query and operational reporting. As part of the BI Productory, we have extended the positioning of Web Intelligence to be also an interactive reporting tool and a self-service dashboarding tool as well. That's the new positioning for SAP Business Object Web Intelligence. For companies willing to create dashboard, we recommend SAP Lumira Designers. And of course, we still continue to propose the Microsoft Office add-on, which is SAP Analysis for Office. Okay, now the core of the presentation. Why Business Object BI 4.3? For the 4.3, we work on three main teams. The first one was hybrid, the second one was user experience, and the last one was enterprise readiness. Hybrid, like I said just a few minutes ago, we like to make sure that all your on-premise investment can be leveraged by SAP Analytics Cloud. So it was the first pillar investment. The second one, which for you, I would say, is more important, is the new user experience you are proposing as part of the BI 4.3. For this, I'm going to detail why this is important and why I think this is one of the main reasons you should go with the BI 4.3. Last but not least, enterprise readiness. This is everything that we did inside the BI platform to make it more easier to install, easier to maintain, easier to audit, et cetera, et cetera. So why user important is, I would say, the main reason to go with the BI 4.3. First of all, we have a brand new BI launchpad. I would say that only the interface is new. All your existing content remain exactly the same, which means that all your sizing cluster, the way you have deployed the BI 4.2, your services remain exactly the same. Going from 4.2 to 4.3 is just an update. And if you decide to do this update inside the BI 4.3, you will get this new BI Fiori launchpad, which is almost exactly proposing exactly the same capabilities that you have in for the two, but inside a Fiori look and feel. What does it mean? It means that the classic launch pads that you have in for the two will no longer be available in for the three. This new launchpad in for the three is 100% functional with what you had in for the two. We are talking about full functional parity. And all the content remain exactly the same, which means that all your security, all your authorizations you will have defined, all your documents, they remain exactly the same and they will continue to work as is. And as part of this BI for the three launchpad, you will find the new web intelligence. So I hope you are all heavily using Webby, because for the three, we expect you to use more web intelligence. And to achieve that, we did several things. First of all, we completely changed the look and feel, like you can notice on the screen. The new web intelligence for the three is fully HTML5, which means that it works on all modern devices, including the touchscreen, for example. All your web intelligence document will work as is, so no change about that. Everything should continue to work even if this is a new interface. We have one client for the web and the desktop, so which means that the web use client remain available but with a new look and feel like for the web client. You still have the web and sorry, you will still have a viewer and a designer experience that you had in for the two. This new Webby is almost on parity with what you had in for the two, which means that some capabilities are still missing in for the three, but I will detail what are missing in a few minutes. To achieve that, we propose a new menu bar, new build panel on the right to achieve formatting and object control. And despite these new settings, we expect that Webby, thanks to this new interface, is really easier to use at the design time, but also at the view time. And all the enhancements I just mentioned are for your end user to make them more autonomous in creating and viewing Webby intelligence document when they will want to create report, but also when they want to create a new dashboard as well. Okay, in addition to these new interfaces that I just mentioned for the BI Launchpad, but also for the Webby, we still have a very strong new capability, which is the Webby data model. So what is it? Imagine that now every Webby intelligence document containing one or multiple queries and also a lot of dimension measures, but also variables can be reused to create new pieces of information. So what I'm describing here, it means that all your existing data stored in every Web Intelligence document can be accessed by Webby to create new pieces of information. That's a huge improvement, because this enables for you the ability to consume what I call the business semantic, meaning that all the queries, variables, all the data created by your business users to answer specific business questions. This kind of information exists only inside Web Intelligence documents. We wanted to open this kind of data to other usage, and this usage is called the Webby data model. So this is all the information that you have inside Web Intelligence document that can be reused to create another Web Intelligence document. And of course, I quickly mentioned that you have, as part of the third pillar, all the cumulative enhancements we did for the BI platform. This is a list a la Prever, but we did a lot of improvement regarding the installer, regarding the security, regarding the BI cockpit and the monitoring. We track more things through the auditing database and so on and so on. I really encourage you to search on the web what's new in BI for the three, and you will get all the details concerning the BI platform, but also Web Intelligence and the semantic layer. Okay, Now, why should you go to Frodo tree? This is the two timelines of the BI Frodo tree and the BI Frodo tree. Today we are March 2021. So we are somewhere, let me check, let me show you highlight pointer option. That is a pointer. We're here at the beginning of the year, first quarter of the year 2021. We just released the service pack one for Frodo tree last December, and we are working on the service pack two for end of this year. And just to let you know that the mainstream maintenance for the BI Frodo tree will be supported until the end of 2025, and the end of mainstream maintenance for the BI Frodo tree is end of 2022. So after we release the service pack two, you will have 1 year to consider moving to Frodo tree, except if you decide to go with the priority one support for the Frodo tree. So that's where I would say a very good reason to start to consider to move to BI Frodo tree service pack one. Quickly, why to go with the Frodo tree service pack one or the BI Frodo tree service pack two? Like I mentioned previously, there is some capabilities that are missing in Frodo tree service pack one that you are working on to make sure they are part of the service pack two. That's the list here. For example, shared element, they will be back in service pack two for the Frodo tree. Extension point, they will be back in the service pack two. FreeZeder in service pack two. The Webby rich client Zabo mode will be back in service pack two, but it doesn't mean that the Webby rich client does not exist today. The Webby rich client is part of the client setup since the Frodo tree service pack zero. And you have cumulative things that you will that you are planning to deliver as part of this pack two. Christian will show them in a few seconds. Another reason to consider the Frodo tree is thanks to some add-on created by our partner Need4Biz. You know, Webby is a very good tool for ad hoc reporting and interactive dashboarding. If you decide to go with the add-ons proposed by Need4Biz, you can transform Web Intelligence, the Webby tool, into a data visualization tool and a data exploration tool. There is a tons of great things that you can expect from this partner, such as Sunburst, really dynamic charts that we do not propose by default. They even propose input controls that you can use inside your Web Intelligence document, but also new type of table that transform really Webby into a data exploration tool. For example, the one here, the pivot table inserted inside Webby transform really your Web Intelligence document in a kind of pivot table or analysis OLAP tool really quickly. That's really, really powerful. I really encourage you to have a look at what they propose today, if you are looking for this kind of usage, data visualization and data exploration. Another thing I would like to mention for you, which is available because I know that many of you are considering moving to the cloud. SAP is proposing a solution which is called SAP Private Cloud Edition, PCE. That's an offer which is available since beginning of this quarter, so beginning of this year, in fact, which is all about taking all your on-premise deployment and make it part of SAP Cloud. By SAP Cloud, you have to understand that it can be any hyperscaler of your choice. In fact, it means that we take your environment and we manage it from A to Z. We do the installation, we do the deployment, we do the update, we do the upgrade, we do the maintenance. And what you have to do is just to bring your content from on-premise to the cloud. And you switch your on-premise licensing model for a subscription model. That's a big change for you. But it's all for good, which means that you will not have to maintain anymore your on-premise deployment. SAP will take care of it. And the good thing also is this is not only SAP. You can decide to work on such a project with your favorite partner, which means that SAP can team work with a partner, your favorite partner, to achieve this. Okay, that's all I wanted to share with you. Now I will let Christian present what's new in BI Frodo tree service pack 2. I will have to share my stop to share now. Christian, up to you.
Okay. Good afternoon. Can you let me know if you see my screen? If you can hear me?
We can.
Okay. So, hello, I'm Christian Soon. I'm working in SAP in Paris in the Web Intelligence team. As mentioned by Grégory, we are currently working on a 4.3 SP2, and I'm going to do some demo on this release. It's mainly a dev environment, so it's still work in progress, but there are still things that are working pretty well, whereas others are not yet finalized. So, first thing we are trying to do is to reintroduce back some missing features from 4.2. And the first one is the shared element. So here, I'm in Web Intelligence in edit mode, and you can see in the main side panel, there is a new tab, which is shared element. The shared element is the ability to select a block in your document to save it in your repository so it can be reused by other power users. For example, here, let's say I'm create a new report in my document, and I want to insert a shared element that has been created by another designer. I select it and I insert it in my document, and everything that has been saved in the shared element, meaning the query, the formatting, is added back in my document. In the side panel, in the tab, you can see all the shared elements that are used in this document. And if I expand the each shared element, I can see the reports in which the shared element is located. Okay. Another way to add a shared element in a document, for example, this logo is used in every report. I want to add another one. I click insert, I add it, and then there's another instance of a shared element in my document. And if I want to save a shared element, I just click the block, right click, shared element, save as, I browse in the repository. And it saved. Okay. And here in the toolbar, you have all the commands to update the refresh element, to unlink it, or to refresh it. Okay. We also wanted to introduce some new innovations in this release. So let's see, for example, in the report. So this is the build side panel where you can set the properties of the report. And here you can see that there's a new text field, which is a description. I say apply, and then the description appear in the tooltip in my report. You can see there's also another option here, which is hide always. If I select it, apply, there's an icon here that is displayed near the name of the report, and it means as a report designer, I want to hide this report to my users, because I want to put in it some formulas, some temporary data. And when I switch to reading mode, the report that has been hidden does not appear. This is good, but there are more. Here you can see, let's say I create another, I duplicate this report. And I will select this option, which is conditionally hide, meaning I can say I want this report to be hidden depending on a formula. So for example, let's say if a margin, if margin return. And here there's another icon. It's not the final ones, but it's an icon to say, okay, this report, let's see what is the value of margin. So the condition is 14 million. The condition is true, and so the report is hidden. let's say I'm going to duplicate this one. I will put a description zip. And I will change the formula. And this time, the formula is false, and it means the report is visible. And when I switch to reading mode, okay, I can only see the report that are visible. If I want to export, okay, this one is visible, but there's a little icon to say it's visible, but there's a condition defined on this report. And if I switch back in edit mode, if I do export, I have three different icons to say the status of each report that I have set. Okay, so this one is the ability to hide the report. Another feature we have introduced in SP2 is the extension of the auto-refresh. In previous release, we have auto-refresh, which is the ability to automatically refresh a report every 10 minutes, for example, or 5 minutes, and to display it on a screen. And so the report can be refreshed during all the day, every 10 minutes. And we have extended this features with the ability to switch automatically into the different tabs of a document. Here, for example, I say, okay, I want the document to be refreshed every 10 minutes, but I want every 2 seconds to switch from one document to another one, from one report to another one. And here you see there's also the little icon to say, because every time the document will be refreshed, the condition about if I need to display the report or not will be evaluated. So meaning at one time a report may be visible, but next time at the next refresh, it may become invisible. Okay. I can also select to display the report in full screen mode. I can hide the refresh bar and the tab. Okay. So here a little bug. In theory, it's supposed to switch in full screen, but I don't know why it doesn't work. It exits the full screen immediately. So it's something I need to work. But in theory, the report should be displayed in a full screen. And here you can see every 2 seconds, it automatically switches to another report. If I want to exit, I click here to exit the presentation mode. Another feature we have reintroduced is the freeze header. So here, we have this toolbar, this little icon in the toolbar. If you click on the icon, it will freeze header for all table in the document, in the report. Okay. And what I can do, I can also select each individual table to say, I don't want to freeze the header on this table. Okay. So it means when I'm going to scroll. Here, the header will not be frozen, but it will be frozen here and here. Okay. Compared to for the two, what we have introduced is we have also introduced this freeze header in edit mode. In for the two, freeze header was available only in reading mode. In this for the three SP2, it's available in edit mode as well. Okay. Now, another interesting feature that has been introduced in SP2 is the ability to retrieve data from your document using OData REST Web Service. So let's see here, I have a table, and I want to extract the data from this table using OData REST Web Service call. It's simple, I just right-click the table, select copy link for OData Web Service, and I have a URL that has been copied by Clipboard. If I'm using this URL in my browser, it won't work because I have no authentication. I've not been in Tantify. However, what I can do if I use to really take advantage of this URL, what I need to do is to create a series of calls to first authenticate and then use the URL I have just generated to retrieve the data. So this is what I'm going to do here. So I put the correct one, this URL here. I'm first going to log in using REST Web Service. I have a session token that I may use in my call. And now when I'm, okay, it's supposed to work, but in theory, I don't know why it didn't work. It was working previously. Anyway, the idea is to, using this URL, you're able to retrieve all data flow from your table or from your query. Okay. So this is the first thing we are doing with OData. The other thing we want to do with OData is the ability to use it as a data source.
Hey, Christian, it's Heather. Yes. I just want to let you know we're just about at time. So if you have something quick you want to show that, you know,
I
that
have
would
a
be
lot
great,
of things to continue to present.
I'm sure there's so many amazing things that you can show.
Let me, give me 5 minutes, okay?
Sure, thank you.
Okay, what I wanted to show is now I want to add a new query. We are going to support both OData as a data source, meaning here you will be able to select the OData entry and put a URL, and it will be it will retrieve the data from the OData call, and you will be able to create your query on top of it. We will be able to use Google Drive as a repository for both Google Sheet, Excel, and text file. Okay, and you will be able to create query on top of it. Of course, if you are using the WebbyRich client, there will be another category, which is local files, and you will be able to select Excel or text file as a data source for WebIntelligence rich clients. Okay. Very quickly, another big topic we are going to propose in FORWARD3SP2 is today in Webby, there's two query panels. The one we call the semantic layer, but the semantic query panel, which is used for UN Universe, Web Intelligence, SAP BW, and SAP HANA. And the other one, which is the custom data provider query panel, which is used for Excel, text, and Fusion SQL. These two query panels are a little different. In the first one, you can add the objects and you add, can add filters, but you cannot set the data type of aggregation for the objects. In the second one, you can select the data type, the object type, but you cannot add filters or select the objects to add in the query. And what you want to do in SP2 is to align these two workflows. Okay, what it means? It means in if you have Excel text file, you will be able to use this query panel, and meaning you will be able to select the objects to add in the query, add filters on top of your Excel or text file, add prompt, and so on, as you do today in on top of Universe. Okay. And on the other side, we would like also to add the ability to set. This is what I'm going to show you here. Once you are in the document, you will be able to rename the objects, set the qualification of the object, data types, aggregation function, add a new description, whatever the object is coming from. It can come from Universe, from Intelligence, SAP BW, or text or Excel. So the idea is to align the two workflows, okay? And here there is this new tab with data properties enrichment. So here I can, as I've shown you, I'm able to change the properties of the objects. If I'm on a variable, I have the ability to very quickly also modify the properties. Oh, sorry, it's, I wanted to do a duplicate. Okay. So here I can very quickly modify the variable property without Sorry, I have to click apply without having to open the formula editor. Okay. And if you want to, you can still open the formula editor by clicking the little button. And so you have all the functions and operator. And finally, perhaps the last thing I would like to show, still about the formula editor. We are going to introduce a new formula editor because the current one, you have little place to type your formula. And in this formula editor, it will support color drawing, parentheses. You see, when I'm, okay, you will be able to. Okay, so much more, a better formula editor to ease how you are creating your formula. And last thing, very last thing, we have also doing a lot of UI improvement. And for example, one of them is the prompt, because in 4.3, the prompt dialog box was a little tiny. And so we have redesigned it to make it look like more like the 4.2 prompt dialog box. Okay, with the two panels. I'm going to run my query and to show you the last thing I wanted to show you. So I think here I'm going to have, you see here there's the little message, no data retrieved in cell details. We have introduced an option to hide all the warning message. Okay, refresh warning. So all the no data to retrieve or partial data, the message that pop-ups, now we, thanks to this option, there are no more displayed. Okay, I need to answer my prompts. And that's it. The message was not displayed. I knew it was a very highly demanded feature. That's it for me. Sorry, it was a little fast. Grégory, perhaps you want to conclude? Thank you.